Come and watch. Come and gather. Come and feel peace through messages of Jesus Christ. Come and see what is possible because of Him.
Welcome back to the show. You're watching GH Today here on GH1 Television. Thank you very much for staying tuned. And you just saw that message from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And that time has come again where they've got something special for you. And they're going to be doing this through, you know, music and messages. Something big is happening on the 7th, the 6th and the 7th of April. And my guests in the studio this morning are here to talk about it. They are from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Paula Balake Wellington is here in the studio. She is Kaneshi Ward for the Kaneshi Stake. Good morning. Welcome.
Good morning.
Thank you very much for joining us in the studio. Good to have you. Also in the studio is Augustine Ajay. He's Stake President, Accra, Ghana Christian Box Day. Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome.
Good morning. Thank you.
Great having you here in the studio.
Good to have you too.
And Brenda Maxawa is here in the studio as well with Accra Christian Box Day. Good morning, Brenda.
Good morning, Lanta.
Thank you for joining us here in the studio. And it's always a pleasure to have you in the studio because there's always something good that you come with. So the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, you know, we always hold a general conference twice a year. So this April, it's happening again. What can we expect for this this April's conference?
Well, this conference is it's going to be a very special one, more especially because it's a worldwide gathering of the church that we get the opportunity to listen to the leaders of the church. They have mastered the art of listening to the voice of the Lord, and they are coming to share with us their experiences and their testimonies concerning Jesus Christ. And that when we get to listen to them, we'll be able to find peace and hope and happiness in this life.
Mm. Yeah, interesting. And I believe there's an invitation, you know, for a lot of people to come out.
Yep.
To be attentive, to listen, to watch. Is the invitation only to members of the church, or it's to everybody?
Absolutely. Invitation is for all persons.
Mm.
Everybody is a son or daughter of God. And when God speaks, you feel His love. It is interesting to hear God speak. So this conference, we are inviting you all to connect with us, to watch, to listen to messages from our leaders, as it will be a renewal of spirit, a refreshing of the soul.
A renewal of spirit.
And a refreshing of the soul.
And a refreshing of the
soul. With music.
With music. And so, I mean, in terms of the, you know, the expectations, because I hear there's music, you know, there's messages. What are the things that people really should be looking out for, and what kind of impact is that going to have on anybody who, you know, tunes in or comes over to come and watch this?
I think as individuals and as communities, we all have questions. We all have questions that we have internally, especially trying to make sense of what life is. I would maybe break it down into three questions. Why are we here on earth?
Mm-hmm.
Did we even come from somewhere before we got here on earth?
Mm-hmm.
What is our purpose in life? And when life ends, where do we go? And these are deep soul-searching questions that each and every one has. And we find answers to that in our own way, some way, somehow. Mm-hmm. And the expectation is that in watching general conference, you can find deep answers to these questions. Responses that answers questions of the soul, basically. And it doesn't matter who you are, where you are from, you can find exactly what you need in listening to General Conference messages. It's almost like the equivalent of listening to the apostles of Jesus Christ, as we know from the Bible. Maybe listening to Peter, Matthew, and just hearing a message that is just tailor-made for you and your specific situation in life.
So with these conferences that are held, you know, all the time, I mean, come April, we hear the messages and all of that. Obviously, it's going to affect your life in one way or another. And, you know, I'm interested in knowing how the conference has affected your life, you know, in terms of, you know, your growth in Christianity, in Christ and all of that. How has that been? I mean, I'm interested in knowing from each of you.
It has a very meaningful impact because I'm a father of three. My wife and myself, it's a bit of a struggle sometimes to think of what your children could become, right? How do you train them up in a way that they will grow to first recognize the promptings of the Spirit and be able to choose what is right, and then to also expand on their capacity to do good, right? And it's every parent's worry if you are so blessed with children in your home. And so with some of these messages that come from General Conference, these are people who have gone through some very good facets of life. And so they share their experience, they share their testimony. They're able to help you to see life from a different perspective.
Right.
And then be able to also build that, help your children or the people around you build that, have that solid foundation in the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that in itself can bring a lot of joy, because we know at this age, those who are like just like me, you know, you can pull your hair, and then, you know, you're thinking every time, what do I do, where do I go? But some of these soothing messages and from our prophets and apostles, they really help you to stay focused, stay balanced, be consistent.
Right.
Just be consistent. You don't need to do a whole lot.
Right.
If you're able to be better than yesterday, I think you've done well enough. And those are some of the impacts that the General Conference messages, they have on people.
On people, yes. You know. Well, what about you? What's your experience, you know, and the impact it's had?
Yes, as humans, we try to be afraid of the future. Afraid of what will come tomorrow. And then we try to withdraw. We think, where is God? What am I doing here? Why are things happening this way? But General Conference is an opportunity to give, to ignite you to want to move further with hope and faith in Jesus Christ and following his teachings. And then you'll be able to strengthen your family so that you will have a personal revelation and an understanding with Heavenly Father. That you are not alone. You have a loving Father who loves you and wants to speak with you. So conferences are special occasions for me and my family. We don't joke about it.
I can tell.
Yeah.
So when and where is the conference happening? And, you know, how can people be a part of it, you know, and get to watch?
I think, as you mentioned previously, the conference happens on the 6th and 7th of April. So it's this Saturday and Sunday. And you can watch it live here, right here on this station on GH1. And also on radio. You can on radio, you can access it at Star FM, on Unique FM in Kumasi, Empire FM in Takrade, A1 Radio in Bogatanga. And the times on 5th April, which is Saturday, you can be able to watch the Saturday morning session, which begins at 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. And it's a live broadcast, meaning it's happening in the USA, but you're able to watch it live here, our time. And then on Sunday, the 7th of April, you can watch the Saturday afternoon session, which is a rebroadcast. And it's also going to last for 2 hours from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. And then in between, there's a music and spoken word, as Sister Wellington said, which would be at 3:30 p.m. to 4 p.m. And then we finally have the Sunday morning session, which would be a live broadcast as well, from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m.
Right, so these are the times that you can get to watch us, and that's what you're seeing on your screen right now. So make sure that you don't miss the broadcasts. and it's going to impact your life in a way that is going to be so beneficial to you and your personal growth. Is there anything else that you wish to share about this general conference?
Yes. We invite you to join us on the 6th and 7th to listen to our dear prophets and apostles as they will talk to us about the love of God, the hope for living, and joy and happiness that we feel after hearing their words. So, if you know you think you have someone, a friend or a brother, a family member that you want to invite and think that will benefit from this conference viewing, come invite them on the 6th and 7th to join us and participate.
That's right. On the 6th and on the 7th. Come and join us. Be a part of it. And where can people find more information about the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints? If anybody wanted more information,
yeah,
you know, about the church, the events, you know, where can they find that?
Right, so it's churchofjesuschrist.org. That is the global portal for messages and information about the church. For West Africa, we have our own website. That's africawest.churchofjesuschrist.org. And then we have comeontochrist.org.
Okay, very well. And anything else to add, yes, Brenda?
Yeah, and to add up to that, I think one thing that's unique about the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints is our missionaries. You usually would see two groups of persons, be it males and females. The males, we call them elders, and the females, we call them sister missionaries. Mm-hmm. I usually see this iconic tag that they have with the church name inscripted, and then their name, elder, and then sister. And you can be able to approach them any day, anytime you see them out there. And they are ready, more than ready, to talk to you about Jesus Christ. That's what it boils down to. Jesus Christ, learning about him and how to find hope and strength. Because life is hard, life is difficult. And sometimes we need direction, sometimes we need answers to try and move life forward and just try and find peace and hope. And we can find that through Jesus Christ. And also the missionaries could help you access that as well. So don't hesitate.
Right. Very well said. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For joining us in the studio and telling us about this. So on the 6th and on the 7th of April, make sure that you are tuning in to GH1TV, to Star FM. Make sure that you do not miss the conference. So thank you very much, Augustine, Brenda, and Paula, for joining us in the studio. And we'll take a short break here. When we return, there's still more to come here on GH Today. We'll be right back.
Come and watch. Come and gather. Come and feel peace through messages of Jesus Christ. Come and see what is possible because of him. We'll be right back.